Talking about seismic shifts, I think obviously one area of our digital existence where we're seeing that on an almost daily basis is in the cryptocurrency market. I'm curious if you have an opinion about that, because I think we continually seem to be on the cusp of it becoming a recognized asset class and part of our daily existence. And then it seems like the threat of government intervention and environmental concerns seems to overnight obliterate that, and obviously the wild fluctuations come. How confident, as someone who's obviously heavily invested in the market and supportive of that as a concept, do you feel about the future, at least in the short to medium term, of crypto?
There's probably not a technological innovation, whether it's social media, whether it was the web, you know, the web, the internet as we know it, that wasn't initially greeted with fear, uncertainty, doubt, pessimism about whether it'll catch on. I read an article the other day from 1990 something where they were saying the internet will never work. They were calling it a bubble, and all the same things. And this is how we greet new things. You have euphoria and wild optimism on one end, and then you have this fear, uncertainty and doubt, and this pessimism on the other. And so the most important thing to do if you're an entrepreneur or an investor that's considering devoting some of your life towards this is trying to drown out the noise and focus on the fundamentals. And reason up from first principles. And when you do that, and when you think about things like smart contracts and from the sort of store of value perspective, the value that having a decentralized asset can bring to certain geographies where there's manipulation of currencies and there's all sorts of problems, the fundamentals would suggest that this is inevitable. And it took me a while to get there myself, but I am there now, and I very much believe that the cryptocurrency blockchain revolution is inevitable, and it's a very good thing. I think the environmental issues will be worked out now that the conversation's being had thanks to Mr. Musk. And I think the legislative issues will also be resolved, as they always are. But I deeply believe that this is inevitable.
I guess the only distinction with cryptocurrency that I think, you know, you talk about decentralization. I guess my final question, how do you respond to people who raise the sort of the moral concern that the lack of regulation and the lack of control, whilst being, you know, obviously liberating for people with money, is also clearly a major tool for people wanting to otherwise pursue illegal and otherwise activities we don't want to see in our society?
Yeah, all of that stuff will be resolved, and you can say the same with cash. Cash is, how do you trace cash? We never banned cash, though, did we? And I think the same applies to cryptocurrencies. Most of the cryptocurrencies flow through regulated exchanges now. And I think as government catches up, which usually takes a decade or two, and understands what it is, they'll put in a framework which helps to mitigate against a lot of the nefarious behavior that is possible. But again, you see the same with all forms of gold and cash. These are all used in nefarious ways. This is a consequence, in fact, of human nature and the fact that we all have a little bit of evil in us, but not necessarily a testament on the moral fortitude of cryptocurrencies. So, yeah.